Hey Johnny, this one's for you. I'm gonna show you how to make beef stew in less than 10 minutes. Got a clock here, notice the counter's empty, got nothing on there. I'm gonna put this on 10 minutes, and the clock starts now. So everything you see is gonna happen all in real time here. Oops. A little noisy. Get that down, get that sound. Cynthia's watching the boys so they don't jump up here. Ingredients, Johnny. Gotta get your ingredients together. Gotta have all your ingredients together. So you got your beef stew, you got your onion, you got your carrots, you got your potatoes, and you got your celery. All set, right? You also gotta get some water. I was gonna drink a beer while I was doing this, but I realized I didn't have any beer. The clock is ticking. Beef stew package. One beef stew mix in the drink. Goes in the garbage. Garbage out. Need something to stir that up with. Cynthia's waving at me over there. So I'm not sure what she's talking about. This here, beef stew meat, already cubed and chopped and ready to wrap and roll from your local butcher. So now that you got this all stirred up, oh, I know what I'm missing. That's what she's telling me. Slow cooker liners, something to put inside your crock pot. So when you do make one of these, easier to clean up. And that's her problem. I cook, she cleans. We should make a show out of this. I need a new job anyway. See, these liners go in. Just wrap around. They're real simple to use. That drops down in there, so that's all that.
How much pressure?
This will be your meat. So you can see the meat, right? So all the meat goes in. Those are garbage. You gotta have all your tools available, right? Sometimes you put the meat in first just to start getting it seasoned. I like pepper. We like lots of pepper, so I always put in more pepper just to make sure that it's seasoned the way I want it seasoned. So then it's just a matter of doing your chopping. That's the easy part, right? If you're a professional chopper,
watch
it. You can make these as big as you want, little as you want. I like them big. Because what happens is when you put them in there over time, they end up shrinking. So if you make them too small, they end up disappearing on you. You want your fingers. So two, maybe three stalks. Get the three biggest stalks you can out there. I have a little problem on the end there, so we'll get rid of that. The big key is to make them all the same size. So that way when they're cooking, they all cook the same. So, whoops. Potatoes. I lost my potatoes.
Juggling is optional.
So then these you're just gonna cut, usually triple cube them. So you take and cut one in half, you slice it long ways, and then you get two more cuts. So you get six pieces out of it. There, you happy now, Steffi? So now you can see? All right, so cut it in half, make a line, split, and split. And if you cut everything, all the same size. I'll say it again, it tends to cook faster and more evenly. So, notice you said you put beans in yours last time, but Oh, beans are a good idea. If you didn't do the beans ahead of time, not a good thing. So this is a long potato, so I'm going to have to do quite a bit more on that. But you can see the cutting part. As long as you got a really nice big sharp knife, I'll eat it. All my garbage all in one. So you keep this, and you keep your garbage in that. You can see the clock is still ticking. I hope you can see that, Jay. Well, this one's for duty too, so you won't have to doctor up his meals afterwards anymore, hopefully. So that's all my, that's five. Oh, we'll go ahead and do the last one, six potatoes. So these are those little red russet potatoes. Just buy them and slice them. I don't have some fancy music going on in the background, so you just have to listen to me for this. And stir it around a little bit while it's going there. So that's done, that's done. Pop open your onion. Onion's the hard part. Everybody hates onions, but tough onions. Once again, you keep one big pile for all your garbage. If you're careful on the onion, you can peel and do a nice job on the onion. See, I usually don't use the whole onion. I usually end up with half of it that I'll keep for doing other things for later on. We make potatoes for breakfast. Throw a little onion in there, things like that. So chop this. I like my onions smaller. Your choice what you want to do on onions, but yeah, mince them all up like so. Some are big, some are small. Doesn't really matter. And the carrots are the hard part, because carrots are tough. That's why we buy these little organic ones, already pre-done, but used to throw them in there just like that. How much time do I have left?
We got 4 minutes.
I got 4 minutes. So now what I do is I just chop them up. I used to put them in there whole. And now instead, chop them up. So up to you how many you want to do, but once again, whatever size you want to do. Carrots in there, some carrots in there. Oh, I'll do about 10 more of these. You can hear them just falling all over the place. Da-da-dee-da-da. I got 4 minutes. Perfect time. Because this is all that's left, is the carrots. Once I get the carrots in there, pretty much after that, add a little bit more water, set the sticks, turn it on, and you're good to go. So, nope, no carrot for me. So it's not quite got enough water, so. Finish stirring up what's left in there. And when you fill it, you want to just stop. So you don't have to put all the water in there, but you want to make sure you get it covered up enough. You know, it's right at the very top. That's that, put the lid on. Should have had this undone here. This plugs in. Set this on low. And the timer for 8 hours. 7:30, 8 o'clock, and I'm dead. I said I was going to clean up too, right? Once I can get them cleaned up and out of the way. So this I'll have to get something. That's pretty much all your garbage, right? The carrots, you notice I didn't use them all, but we use carrots on other things. So what I'll do is get a couple bags. Just got, happen to have some Ziploc bags here. Not putting any work for Ziploc, but there they are. How much time we got left, Cincy?
We got about a minute.
A minute, huh?
Yeah. Time's up.
Those will go in the refrigerator like so. garbage. And these will go in the sink to be washed. So there you have it. Right at 10 minutes, you heard the buzzer. And we're done. Dinner in about 8 hours. See you tonight.